Hey guys, it's Cranky B. I've actually got my kitchen all torn apart today just because, well, I'm starting to build a PC here. I'm using my phone to record this mainly because I haven't made videos in so long, all my camera batteries are dead, and I'm not even sure where the chargers are. But anyway, doing it on top of the stove in the kitchen because A, it's a flat surface, and B, it's right near the sink, which I can touch to ground myself of any static charge to avoid damaging any of these components. Now, some people think that's overkill, and it may be, but I don't want to ruin anything. And when you can take such a simple precaution like that, I don't see why you wouldn't. It's kind of foolish. But anyway. Now, let me tell you a little bit about this rig. It's not nearly finished. I don't have all the parts yet, but I've just been buying like a few parts here and there when they're on sale to save some money so I ultimately can build a better PC for the same budget. So, let's see what we've got here. This case is by Corsair. It's the Obsidian Series 750D Airflow Edition, which just means it has these dust filters and these case fans already installed. And I'm still wearing this stupid anti-static bracelet. Take that off. Another PC builder's friend. Stupid and cheap, but it helps keep you from destroying things. There's a reason these components come in anti-static bags, and because static electricity can very much damage them. Anyway, so this is the processor, the Intel Core i7 7700K. Obviously, the socket is the LGA 1151, and it's on the ASUS Prime Z270A motherboard. Some people say it's like a entry-level motherboard. It seems pretty good to me. It's suitable for pretty decent overclocking, which I'm not going to do because I don't know anything about this stuff, you guys. I really don't. I realized a few weeks ago that the computer I play on is really outdated. It's from 2010, so it's 7 years old. The newest parts in it are from 2012, and it's not even close to being able to run the most modern games, so I realize it's time for an upgrade. Sorry about the sniffling. I really shouldn't be doing that on video. It's kind of gross. Anywho, so to cool this beastly processor, I mean, I know it's not the best one out there, but it's a really good one for gaming. I've got the Noctua NHU14S heatsink. As you can see here, it is installed. It's got a huge fan on it, and it's just this monster heatsink. I mean, the CPU is this big, but the heatsink's huge. It's kind of funny. Intel doesn't include a heatsink anymore with the processors. Maybe some of them they do, but they don't include a heatsink with this one. So, fortunately, I knew that when I was buying it, so I ordered this guy. And I'm sure it's overkill because I'm not planning on overclocking anything, at least not until I learn more about computers, because I know enough to get me in trouble, but I'm not an expert on computers. And I really don't see a need in my situation to overclock. I mean, I'm putting some pretty powerful components in this thing, so I shouldn't really have any issues, at least not for a few years, till the software gets more demanding of better hardware, and then maybe I'll look into overclocking at that time. I actually just picked up this memory from Best Buy today. It's this PNY Anarchy DDR4 or whatever. Yeah, obviously I needed DDR4 because that's what the motherboard takes, but I paid $140 for that, Which, I mean, RAM prices are ridiculous right now. But that's 16 gigabytes of RAM, which should be more than enough for anything I want it to do. I have a hard time using 8 as it is, but some of the new games might be a little bit more memory hogs, I'm not sure. But that same amount of memory, the best price I could find on Newegg for a brand that I thought I could trust was about 190. So that's pretty good savings. $40 or $40 to $50, depending on what the tax was. But so, like, I hadn't even had memory until today. I just bought it today, and I wanted to have that installed before I put the cooler in. Let's see. I ordered the case, the motherboard, CPU, and the cooler all the other day. Case came first. And then all the other stuff came the next day. But I couldn't install the cooler till I had some RAM in there. And I'm slightly bothered by I'm getting an M.2 SSD. And it kind of overhangs the slot there. Come on, focus. That's the slot right there for the M.2, and as you can see, if you sit here level with it, it's overhangs it a little bit, but there's quite a bit of clearance in there, so I think there's enough room to tip that up and slide it in and then lock it down. Otherwise, there's another M.2 slot down here. I think that's the one you want to use if you're only using one. I think that's the one you want to use up there. It's already configured for PCIe, so and that's the only one on this board that can do SATA. This one's PCIe only, cannot support SATA. I don't really know if it really matters which one you use if you only use one, but everybody seems to prefer the one up closer to the CPU, so I'll probably do the same. But like I said, I think I can get it in there without taking the heat sink off. I hope so, because otherwise I wouldn't ever put it on. Although it's really not that big a deal. They give you a lot of thermal paste with it, so you can take it off, put it back on a few times. No big deal. I might even buy more thermal paste and use a different kind. I don't know. I think a lot of that stuff's overrated. People have preferences based on essentially no evidence. Oh, this thermal paste is better than that thermal paste, but they don't have a reason why. Anyway, like I said, I don't really know very much about any of this crap. I'm not really sure how any of it works. I know how to put the parts together because I mean, you almost can't do that wrong. But so I'm planning on getting a Samsung 960 Evo SSD. Stupid, stupid fast. Slightly slower than the 960 Pro, but it's still ridiculously fast, and the price point is a lot more friendly to your wallet than the 960 Pro. I don't really see any practical benefit to spending that much more for a little bit faster. But I've got right here a 1 TB Western Digital Blue, kind of basic home drive. I was gonna get a Seagate 2 TB online, but I made them price match that at Best Buy today. Here's the box for it. Just a basic. But I thought about it, and A, I've never used a whole terabyte before, and B, the 1 TB single platter drives are more reliable, so it probably is less likely to fail on me, which without having an external hard drive, I really don't want it to fail because then I'll lose all my data. I'm planning on getting an external, I just don't have one yet. And since I'm putting all my computer budget into this build right now, I mean, this thing's gonna end up costing over 2 grand when it's all said and done. I think I got almost 1,000 into it right now. Pretty close to 1,000, but I still got a couple more parts to buy. That SSD costs about 300, well, a little bit less than 300. The SSD, I think it's more like 250 something. And then the graphics card, I'm not cheaping out on at all. I'm gonna get the GeForce GTX 1080 Ti, which is one of the most powerful cards out there. And that thing runs over $700 for just that one part. So that's expensive, but it's a crazy powerful graphics processor. And that's the only thing. I think the way it's built is everything hangs off this side of the board, so it'll be fine. But if anything sticks up off the board, I'm going to have a clearance issue with this cooler, and I'll probably have to turn it, which I'd rather not do, because right now, you know, the airflow is right in line with the case fan. You know, we got an inlet here. It kind of had to come up a little bit, go through the CPU cooler, and then exhaust directly through this case fan, which is really nice. Otherwise, I'll have to turn it. And if I turn it, I want to have the fan on the bottom side blowing up, because I don't want to blow all that heat right at my graphics card. That doesn't make a lot of sense. But the only issue with that is I don't think it gives you very much more clearance than it is now. But I'm pretty sure the way the card's designed is everything hangs down from the board. So I don't think it'll really be a problem. I won't know until I got it in there and see. But yeah, that's basically it. I chose Asus because they're the manufacturers of the computer I use now, and it's been the most reliable computer I've ever had. I've been using it for 7 years. It still works great. I've made a few upgrades to it, but I mean, it's got basically all the original components except for the power supply. Then it's got some added in. So, anywho, this has been a little longer than I wanted it to, but I've got an EVGA 750 watt power supply. I ordered it yesterday, so that'll be here within a few days. And that's another thing I like, a bottom mounted power supply. And you can either put the fan up, drawing air out of the case, excuse me, drawing air out of the case this way, or you can put it down. And this is a little dust filter in the bottom there. And so it can have like its own little system going there for the power supply. So I'm not sure. I'll probably end up just choosing whichever way is more aesthetically pleasing at this point. This case does have a nice acrylic window on the side. Not as nice as tempered glass, but it's a lot cheaper. And it's lighter anyway. There's the side of it. I haven't peeled the stuff off yet, but it should be nice and clear. But I think there's some lights back here on the motherboard, but I don't really care about lights. I'm not like trying to show off or anything. If I was trying to show off, I'd have probably got a CPU cooler with a black fan, because this is kind of an ugly fan, this tan and brown. But supposedly the performance is really, really good on these Noctua coolers. So I'm gonna just stick with that, and you know, the fan that comes on is probably a really good fan, and whatever I put on there, if I change it, probably wouldn't be as good, so I'll just leave it. Anyway, that's that. So all I've got left to put in here is the power supply, the solid state drive, the GPU, and I'm gonna put an optical drive in. I know you don't really need them anymore, but I'm gonna put a Blu-ray drive in here. That way I can read and write all types of discs. It's not that expensive, it's like less than $60. So one thing I just did before I started the video was I had to pull the motherboard back away a little bit. This little piece on the IO panel, that sticks next to the USB 3.1 port. That was bent and it was covering up the port a little bit. I had not noticed that when I put the motherboard in, so I just did that real quick. Bent it out of the way, and I don't know, this IO panel's off a little bit. Looks like the USB-C port would be a little bit hard to use, although I don't have anything that uses a USB-C at the moment, so that's not really a big deal either. It's got HDMI and DisplayPort and DVI and all that crap that you're not even going to use because you're going to have a dedicated graphics card, but it's cool they put that stuff there for people who aren't really gamers. Got four USB 3 ports on the back, and it's got down here a USB 3 plug here, so you can have a module on the front. Got two more USB 3s and then a couple of USB 2s as well. So, take care, guys. Thanks for watching.